Hello there, real over 1239 here, and I'm here with a little bit of news. I believe these are just rumors, considering I've only seen one article on it. There's a couple videos and stuff, but this is the article that people have been spreading around. Weirdly enough, found it first on Facebook by just, I don't remember where what was on there. I don't think a friend shared it or anything. I think it was just a page. And that must have been, well, it's 11:30 now, p.m., and I think I saw it about 9 a.m., so it's been out there for a while. I think it was this one. Maybe it's a different one, because the date looks off. Anyways, so, as you can see by the title, YouTube to acquire video game streaming service Twitch for $1 billion, yeah, so basically, if you don't understand what that means for some reason, like something's wrong with you, YouTube or Google, because YouTube is owned by Google, is planning on buying Twitch, which I think is going to be a great idea, because for a long time, I've wanted to stream to YouTube and Twitch, but oh, there's no things that does both. You'd have to do a lot of trickery thing. Also, Twitch is kind of bad because with the adverts and sponsoring, so you can only get sponsored through Twitch. You can't, I believe IGN for a while, but not anymore. You only can get partnered through Twitch now. The good thing about Twitch is you can get or paid through PayPal, which YouTube you can't, but whatever. Also, YouTube has a bigger audience, so if they start integrating stuff, I think that would be a huge thing. Hopefully they don't just get rid of Twitch. It's like you buy Twitch for $1 billion and you just disband it. Like, that would be pretty depressing. I think this is gonna be a good thing, but I'm almost certain there's gonna be a lot of people who are gonna hate this. And again, as you see here, reps for YouTube and Twitch declined to comment, meaning they were asked to make a comment on this, and they said, they can't comment right now. So, just reading, Google's YouTube has reached a deal to buy Twitch, a popular video game streaming company, for more than $1 billion. According to sources familiar with the pact, I think that means just their sources. So I don't know how reliable they are. We don't know who they are. We know there's some sources. It could be some guy who just was in the basement going, "What can I make controversial?" And then they put this up. That could have been their source. You don't know how reliable they are. But assuming they are, we'll go with that. The deal in all cash offers is expected to be announced immediately, sources said. If completed, the acquisition would be most significant in the history of YouTube, which Google acquired in 2006 for $1.65 billion. The impending acquisition comes after long-time Google ad exec, Susan Wojcicki, was named CEO of YouTube earlier this year. So that's just saying it's going to be a big deal for YouTube and Google in general. San Francisco-based Twitch lets users upload and watch free. I don't think it lets you upload, does it? It's a good question. I have another monitor open. Let's look. Go to Twitch. I'm not very good at reading out loud, unless of course it's not 11:30 at night, so most likely I'm gonna screw up a lot of words. So yeah, I don't see any way of uploading to Twitch. I see a lot of streaming, don't see any uploading. If I go to dashboard, I could just show you my no, because it shows the stream key and stuff like that, so maybe not. There, if I go to dashboard, Twitch is no longer saves archives by default, if you like to, alright. No, you have recorded highlights, bookmark, editing, activity, stats, stream key. But it doesn't look like you actually can upload. So that's again, it's a small thing, but you just upload and watch free. Just saying upload, and there's an ad playing. I think you guys could probably hear that. Maybe not. I don't know. You guys might be able to hear that. I couldn't. I have my headphones off. I can actually hear it through my headphones. Like, it's pretty loud. And that's what I mean. Twitch has pretty bad ad integration. So, like with YouTube, if you have a copyright or stuff like that, you might have then you have ads, but they don't just put ads on some random person's video who has done nothing wrong and is not partnered or anything like that. So that's pretty good with YouTube, but Twitch, I even believe if you skip the ad, because some of the ads have skip ad button, it just loads a different ad. You skip the ad, it loads a different ad. It's pretty stupid. Live gameplay videos, which could be streamed from Microsoft, Xbox, and PlayStation 4 consoles, also PC. but yeah, so it is Twitch. If you don't know, Twitch is mostly gaming. There's a little bit of meh, like the creatures who do their podcasts on there. It's not gaming, but it's people find it entertaining. I don't think I'm really gonna complain, especially if they're getting hundreds and hundreds of views. The company claims to have more than 45 million monthly users, with more than 1 billion members who upload videos each month. Again, that's I didn't see. There might be a way to upload, but I didn't see it, so it's hidden somewhere. It also has deals to distribute shows from partners, including CBS Interactive GameSpot, Joystick, and Destructoid. I don't know what those are, but yeah, apparently distribute stuff. YouTube is preparing for U.S. regulations to challenge the Twitch deal. I'm not actually. I don't live in the U.S., so I don't know what those. You know what it might be? Because they one of their deals might be, because it is strictly cash only. So I think that means they'll just get the $1 billion. There's no other like. Well, you still get 5% of our monthly revenue from Twitch. I think it's just $1 billion. So I think they're waiting for the US regulations to challenge the deal. According to sources, YouTube is far and away the number one platform for internet video, serving more than 6 billion hours of video per month to 1 billion users worldwide. Yeah, and that's a, in case you're wondering, that's a lot. And the company expects the Justice Department to take a hard look at whether buying Twitch raises anti-cooperative issues on the online video market. I didn't know, actually, that's interesting, because I didn't know America had those type of things. I thought that was one of the problems that with the American economy, was that you had too many just what's it called, monopolies. Not like a board game, but like you actually had too many monopolies, which is why why one of the, I believe, the stock market went down in America. Because I in Canada, like there, I believe, I don't think it could be longer than 75 years ago, maybe longer. I don't know. There was a oil company. I don't remember the name of the oil company, but it had the monopoly. And when any other oil company would come up and make a business, they'd just get bought out or just run out of business because the bigger oil company was getting all the money. So the Canadian government split in half. So half of the company went to, was a different company now. And then the prices of oil dropped because instead of one person having a monopoly, then it's like with medicine. If one person has one person one at least in Canada, if a person has makes a drug, they get to put the name on it, so like Advil, and after and then for 10 years that drug is going to be through the roof in prices, and then after those 10 years other people can start making a drug and prices would drop to like $2. So it's pretty cool that way. So it's nice to know that America has something like that. Twitch was launched in June 2011 by Justin Kahn and Emrit Shear. Those are exactly how they're pronounced, and there's no way butchering any of those names. Co-founder of Justin.tv. Oh yeah, especially not butchering this name. That was exactly how it was pronounced, however I said it. One of the first websites to host live streaming user-generated video. Shear currently serves as CEO of Twitch. Founded in 2011, the startup has raised about $35 million in funding, investors including Bezemer, Venture Partners, Alsup Lewis Partners, West Summit Capital, Take-Two Interactive Software. I recognize Take-Two. Aren't they I think they're game-making software. I think they made some good games. Again, let's just look it up. Take-Two. That's TWIP. Good job, Jordan. Oh, Take-Two. Take-Two Interactive. Yeah, Take-Two Games. Let's see what games they made. Again, I probably should just put this on the other monitor so you guys can look, but meh. Oh, Take-Two didn't. Apparently, they're Grand Theft Auto 5 coming soon. Borderlands, the pre-sequel. Let's find a game. Let's buy title. Grand Theft Auto 5. Oh, so they are. I think there might be a sub. Grand Theft Auto 5, Red Dead Redemption, Grand Theft Auto, Episodes from Liberty City, and then it goes to NBA 2K14. I don't know who they are. Our labels. Rockstar Game Labels. Game Labels founded in 1998 to create the most interactive, progressive, interactive entertainment. Publishers such as popular games. Publishers of such popular games as Grand Theft Auto, Midnight Club, Red Dead Redemption, Max Payne, Bully, Manhunt, and more. And then founded 2005, 2K publishes title. I don't know what they do. Let's go to store. Again, you guys are going to be very entertained on me just reading. Hopefully my voice is incredibly entertaining. So it looks like they're just like Rockstar and 2K restricted. Because when I go to store, it says visit online stores. Head over to the storefront at www.rockstarwarehouse.com or store.2k.com for merchandise and games from our Rockstar and 2K labels. Please choose a store below. Well, so there you go. Whatever that means. If you want to go to Take-Two, you're just going to get a bunch of Grand Theft Auto or Rockstar and 2K games for some reason. Then Thrive Capital and Daper Accessories. One of Twitch's competitors is Major League Gaming, a New York-based company whose investors include Oak Investment Partners and Relative Media CEO Ryan Mvanica. I'm actually going to... Here, I'll show this to you. I'll just go to MLG. Eventually. Major League Gaming. Major League Gaming. Not Major League, Major League. Alright, so... this is a lot different than the website I remember. I thought they streamed on Twitch themselves. I guess not. Yeah, Call of Duty. You can actually play in a... Yeah, I don't know why I'm here. But yeah, so... Yeah, that's... I didn't know Twitch actually did this. I knew they used to do their stuff on their channel, but I thought maybe they just moved over to Twitch or something like that. Just seems like a right thing to do, but whatever. In March 2014, Twitch represented 1.35 of their downstream bandwidth on North American fixed access broadband networks. Nearly triple last fall, according to the bandwidth equipment company Sanvine. Sanvine. And then, yeah, that ends. So, go on my last statements. No idea what it means. I'm great at this. So yeah, that's just the news on the YouTube acquire video game streaming service Twitch for $1 million. Again, it's just sources, anonymous sources. The article is made. Deals are just bigger. So yeah, the article is made by this guy, but I don't think he's the source. Because it said, yeah, familiar with the pact. I don't know what that means. Again, so you could have just heard, he could have a guy that works at Google who went, yeah, I've heard a little bit of talk between them and Twitch, you know, just a little bit of talk. And they took it the wrong way and went, yeah, they're buying it. It could just be simple like that. And then you can say, well, this guy works at Google and he's the one that told me. And then you have no reason to disbelieve him, so what are you going to do? All in all, I think if this does go through, I think it's going to be a good thing for YouTube. I'll thoroughly enjoy it, especially if I... What I would like is if I start streaming on Twitch, I wouldn't mind a little notification on my channel that I'm streaming on Twitch. That would also be a nice thing. But, yeah, that's my thoughts and, complaints and... kind of just questioning this in general. Hopefully you enjoyed. You can look in the more articles. Article will be in the description of the video. So, yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy. Bye-bye.